But true crime news is a bit different this week, as two cases, more or less, have taken over the news media. So therefore, we decided to cover each of the cases in separate videos. You will find a link to the other video at the end of the one you are watching right now. But as usual, we will have a video up for you guys where we cover different cases of the week as we used to do. In the case of serial killer Todd Coolhip, there has been a lot of news in the media the past week. We will look into this news in this exclusive video. The first pictures of the hellhole container where Coolhip is said to have held Caleb Brown captivated and chained like a dog for months have been revealed. To blend the container into the environment, sex offender Coolhip had painted the container green. Besides, the container was laid onto cinder blocks, preventing it from descending into the ground. The green container was well hidden from the view of motorists on the road outside the property of Todd Coolhip. A forensic psychologist has given an explanation to how one man has been able making these awful crimes and what makes serial killers tick. Dr. Deborah Lebrowski explains the most common, unfortunately, is thrill, excitement, lust, power, and some sexuality. It seems as Dr. Deborah thinks it's most likely sexual deviancy coupled to these crimes. In Deborah's opinion, only time will tell if the guilt Coolhip is showing at the moment is genuine or it's just a way trying to save himself. Todd Coolhip has made some chilling Amazon reviews. Those were surreal in the past week. On a review of a knife posted on September 13th, 2013, he said, "Haven't stabbed anyone yet. Yet, but I am keeping the dream." On another Amazon review for a show, Coolhip posted this review, "Keeping car for when you have to hide the bodies, and you left the full-size shovel at home." Todd Coolhip is thought to have written the reviews for weapons in the months before Caleb Brown was found chained in his container. Investigators say they found at least 5 guns on Coolhip's property in rural South Carolina. The stash included at least 1 assault rifle. Records show Coolhip never tried to buy a firearm legally. Documents from the court include a psychiatric evaluation on Coolhip. It says Todd Coolhip destroyed his room with a hammer, he bleached a goldfish, he destroyed other children's projects, he was dismissed from Boy Scouts as he was too disruptive and shredded his new clothes. He shot a dog with a BB gun. A reporter told Coolhip's father had said the only emotion his son was capable of showing was anger. At the age of only 15, Todd Coolhip was charged for the kidnapping of a 14-year-old girl whom he forced into his home where he tied her hands, placed tape over her mouth, and sexually assaulted her. Widow of one of the 4 victims in a more than decade-old infamous case known locally as the Superbike Murders said the woman held captive, she is referring to Caleb Brown, is the real hero. The killings took place in 2003 where Coolhip shot 4 people. The widow Melissa Pounder says police have spent years tracking down leads and kept reminding the public about the case, but the case remained cold until Brown's rescue. Therefore, Brown should be given the $25,000 reward that has long been offered in the case. Brown, who was hired to clean the homes Coolhip was selling, went to Coolhip's property with her boyfriend when the alleged serial killer pulled out a gun. 2 cops who rescued Caleb Brown from the serial killer tearfully recall how they found her chained up in a shipping container and what they saw will never leave them. After Kayla's rescue, she told police she witnessed how Coolhip shot her boyfriend, whose body was found on the property. The last victims of the Carolina serial killer, Todd Coolhip, has been identified. The victims were a young couple Coolhip shot dead a year ago and whom he buried behind the dungeon container. The couple, Megan and Johnny Coxey, vanished shortly before Christmas 2015. The couple both had a history of petty crime and panhandling, but had become parents in September. Megan's mother reported her daughter and son-in-law missing on December 22nd last year. It was just 4 months after they had posted pictures of a new baby on social media. Megan was shot once in the head and her husband suffered several bullet wounds to the torso. Both were found in shallow graves and they were both fully clothed. The couple got identified through their tattoos and dental records. The mother of Todd Coolhip has defended her son by saying her son is not a monster. He is misunderstood. She hates her son being called a serial killer and she claims he didn't do it for enjoyment. Coolhip's mom says he did it because he was angry and hurt. When asked why her son tied up Kayla Brown, she told CBS she had seen him kill her boyfriend and he didn't know what to do with her. He couldn't turn her loose, she would get the police. Regina Tate says her son told her he killed Carver because he got nasty and was smart-mouthed. To the question why her son killed the owner and employees at the Superbike Motorsports, Tyke said her son wanted to return a motorcycle and they laughed at him, made jokes at him. Tom Lucas, the father of slain service manager Brian Lucas, said he heard differently. Tom Lucas thinks Coolhip had a purchase of a bike that didn't go well. He messed it up and it got stolen, so he came in and bought another bike. In the shop, they were kind of playing with him, laughing and saying, "You're gonna mess this one up," or something like that. A small comment like that set him off, and therefore 4 people had to die. Nobody deserved to die over a comment like that, Tom Lucas concluded. And without further ado, we will take you into the latest news on the case. Even though we should reveal this for you guys next week, we thought it was interesting news, so here you go. It has been revealed how Megan Coxey met Todd Coolhip. She met him while she was working in a waffle shop. A man who had been employed with Mrs. Coxey at the Waffle House told that Todd Coolhip came in frequently and invited the waitress to his house. Coolhip tried to warm up the ladies by leaving large tips for meals, but his creepy behavior didn't go over well. A co-worker, a cook who has requested not getting mentioned, began ringing up Todd Coolhip's orders to spare the women from having to. The co-worker told WBTW he knew for a fact Coolhip didn't just pick Megan up off the street. He met her at the waffle shop. Both families to Mrs. and Mr. Coxey has asked the police to make a request to the news media to respect their grief and privacy. For more information, look in the description and find relevant links to articles. If you don't want to miss out on any crime news, follow us on Facebook, Pinterest, or Instagram. And, of course, subscribe to our channel.